Good morning. It is a brilliant day in St. Helena. 62 degrees right now. It's a little bit on the early side for me. It's just before 9 a.m. But I'm up early because a friend of mine, Mr. Anthony Arcudi, very talented winemaker, has invited me up to a vineyard where he sources the grapes for his wine called Arcudi. I'm really excited to see it. It's way up on the top of Howell Mountain. I think it's the highest elevation vineyard on Howell Mountain. If it's not, it's like the second highest, but it's supposed to be pretty spectacular, and I've been dying to see it, and he invited me up to do a little tasting and a tour of the vineyard. So I'm going to meet him at arguably one of the best spots in St. Helena. They have what Einegarden considers the best English muffins in the world, and Oprah as well. The English muffins were a feature on Oprah's Favorite Things, so I am going to take you to
the Model Bakery. And they serve Stumptown here, so it's a great place to come for a little breakfast and a little coffee. Just beware the lines can get a little bit long.
Say hello.
Hi, Tony.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Tell me your name.
Tony Arcudi.
And what do you do?
I'm a winemaker. You've probably been to a lot of vineyards by now.
Been to a few, yeah.
This isn't like anything else.
So where are we going?
We're going to the Black Sears Vineyard on the top of Howell Mountain.
How high up is that?
2,400 feet.
2,400?
2,400 feet. Yeah, we're getting there. Your ears are going to pop. It's the highest on Howell Mountain. It's above the inversion layer. Every night, the cool air comes into Napa Valley, and it forms this fog layer. It's called the inversion layer. That inversion layer moves out every day. So this is above that. So if you get up here in the early morning, you're looking down on like a cloud cover, which is really cool because vineyard gets very early morning sun, which is mild. And then as the day goes on, the heat goes up, the afternoon sun is really harsh. This vineyard gets shaded from that. That's one of its unique characteristics. And that's because of the elevation.
The vineyard is biodynamic. Does that mean it's also organic or just bio?
You couldn't be biodynamic
without being organic.
Yeah. So there's a number of different ways to look at it. It's almost like a higher level of organic. Mm-hmm. Really just organic with another layer on top in terms of how you produce your compost, things like that. And you can see it in the vines. They're healthy. You know, and at the end of the day, you want best tasting fruit for the best tasting wine. Like when I worked at Chapoutier, I asked them, so why do you do biodynamic? And they said, at the end of the day, it's better wine. And we truly believe in it. And they've done lots of studies. You can see, like if you look at Hermitage Hill, their blocks are the last to drop their leaves. You know, the vines really appreciate it. Going to be at least 2 weeks behind the valley pool. Because it's cooler in the winter, the bud break is going to start later, and it's also harvested later. Because of the exposure, so we have this morning sun, and then in the afternoon it's shaded. As the season goes on and the sugar levels are climbing, for some reason this vineyard just kind of levels out. So what's great about that is that the flavors have time to develop.
So you're reaching phenolic ripeness at the same time as sugar level.
Gotcha. Exactly.
Which is always difficult.
It is difficult.
We just got to Fantesca, and this is actually where Tony makes his wine, and he's the assistant, or excuse me, say one more time. He's the associate winemaker here at Fantesca. It's a really beautiful property up on Spring Mountain here. I'm gonna taste some of his wines, see what he's got going on.
So we're looking at this is the 16 vintage. There's 3 barrels of Pritchard Hill, which is new, so this is the first vintage. It's the Howell Mountain barrels here.
Where we just were today.
We just were.
So same grapes, 3 different barrels.
Same vineyard, 3 different barrels. The Terenceau is very respective of the wine. To me, it's true what the French would call élevage, right? Where you're elevating the wine. Terenceau does a great job of that. It makes the wine more of what it is.